this is the energy vibration reading for the Gemini Sun, Moon, and Rising. I want to say thank you to each and every person that is here. Welcome back. This is the month of November 2017, and the month is the energy vibration of the Hurt energy. It is the energy of the world. So this is a wonderful month to bring balances. So a lot of endings are going to be happening. And a lot of new beginnings. It's a month if you're about to do anything that is positive and has something to do with your that is going to benefit you and other people. It's a good month to start it. Like people who write books and that sort of a thing, it's a good month to start it. I was sick. I had the flu. My eyes are still tweety, and my nose is still really stopped the alpha. Okay, so your month, actually there is a lot of positive things. What I love with your month is that the energy of the sun and the wheel of fortune comes to the two last week in the month. So the energy, your best week is going to be the second week, okay? Your best week is going to be the second week. Here we have another double. A lot of, well, I've just started readings for you guys, but you have the double sun, and the Aquarians people had the double wheel of fortune. So here it is that a lot of positive energies, a lot of stuff is really happening for you guys, okay? So let me go on and see what is your number energy. As I have said, we have the sun. There is a lot of there is a focus. There is something with 13 or 31 in this month. There's a lot of threes, and the threes are the energy vibration of the threes are the energy vibration of the ascendant master. So obviously there is a situation that is going on in this month with the energy of the ascendant masters. Okay, we have the sun. Okay, so write these numbers down. I will try to say them in the correct order, and if not, okay, let's look at this. We have the number three. Okay, number three, then we have number 19, 3 and 19. There is a focus on the 3 and 19. Okay, whatever the situation is, this is 7, 6, 5. 3 and 19, because there is also 5. So 3, 5, and 19. There are 3, 2, 5, and 19. 3, 2, 5, and 19. 3, 2, 5, and 19. Two times, and then 11. 11. Okay, this is good. This is wonderful. I think I'm going to do this before your readings. Okay, let's get in the reading. Remember the first week, okay? The first week is going to be the energy of destiny. Destiny is the energy vibration of a fire sign, okay? The fire energy. So the first week is going to be a fire energy. Destiny, you're finally seeing a truth of a situation. The tower has fallen, and you're finally seeing the truth of the situation. So the tower has fallen, and you are finally seeing situations that you weren't seeing before. Okay, the tower has fallen, and you're finally seeing situation that you have not seen before. So this is very good. Whatever the situation is, you need to understand, and you need to know that whatever is happening, the tower, whatever that was happening that you weren't aware of, is as if all the secrets are going to be coming out. All secrets are going to be coming out. You're going to see the truth of a situation, and this must take place. Okay, so if anyone was lying to you, hiding anything, things are going to start coming out of the cuss. So all the people who have been hiding things from their partners, be aware, because things are about to come out that you weren't expecting to come out. Okay, all right, I'm trying to retrain myself not to use my glasses. Let's look at the second week. Second week is a wonderful week. It's one of your best week because you have an air energy. You are bringing balance to a lot of stuff. This is a week of balance that will affect each and everyone on this planet. With this energy of balance, you have the energy of the Mother of Pentacles, which is the Queen of Pentacles. And there is a situation, it's as if you are really realizing how wonderful this person is, okay? For some of you Geminis, you're just really wondering and realizing, oh my God, this person was really, really nice. This person was really a nice person. And whatever the situation is, there is going to be whatever that was injustice against both of you. There is going to be a balance, and you are going to be extending the hands, or this person is going to be extending the hand. So look around you to see what misunderstanding, miscommunication, misjustice that has happened between you and someone who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Because whatever had transpired between you both, you finally seen the truth about the situation, and you are going to be you know, like saying sorry, because the lily is always, and yellow is friendship, and you are going to be extending the hands and opening up and saying sorry. Someone is going to come to you and say sorry, or you are going to go to the person and said, oh my God, I'm so sorry for what happened. You know, as if you're finally seeing what exactly took place, and you're going to say, oh my God, I'm so sorry, I never knew that just something that I said could have cost you your life. Okay, so that sort of a thing, something like that played. So what you're going to try to do is, you know, bring the energy of the lily in and bring justice and say sorry, because you have realized that you have nearly cost someone their lives, okay? And there's really their lives, but it could that something that you have done in the past had affect someone, this person, this Queen of Pentacles, who is a Taurus, a Virgo, or a Capricorn, and now you really, really realize what took place, and you are blown away. And you want to bring peace because you want to regain the friendship of that person. Okay, as we go forward, we have the energy vibration of sacrifice. You are going to be sacrificing yourself. The weirdest thing is that these two comes out, okay? The Four of Pentacles and this woman. So, okay, this is something for us to look at deeply. Okay. All right. You have sacrificed yourself. Mother of Swords. The Mother of Swords is you, Geminis. You, Gemini women. Try to save. The third week is going to affect a lot of you Gemini women, because what is happening here is that you are the Mother of Sword, the energy vibration of the Four of Pentacles. You're trying to balance your financial world, and you want to balance your financial world because there is someone, or as if you're in a guidance is saying to you, put away a little thing. So, maybe there is something that you really, really want for yourself, but you're constantly thinking about other people and that sort of a thing. And it's as if your angels and guides are saying, put away a little of this. Try and bring your financial world in balance so that you can move out of the self-poverty, of the poverty in strict that you have had yourself in. And this is going to what is going to happen, because it's a life, it's a sacrifice. It's a, as if you have been always sacrificing yourself and you decide to stop. It's as if the angels and guides are saying stop. And by saying that and doing that, you are going to realize how wonderful it is going to be that you can transform yourself in the third week. As we look at the fourth week, we have the energy of death and transformation. This death and transformation came up with the energy of the sun twice. So the fourth week is going to be a wonderful, positive week. Whatever you are about to start in this week, yes, go ahead. Yes, two times. Go ahead. The double energy of the sun. For some people, you're going to feel yourself. You're going to feel the energy of yourself coming back. You're going to feel the radiation of positive energy coming back to you, coming back in your life, understanding where you are, understanding the place, understanding the values of who you are. You are going to feel as if the universe and the sun and its own self is pure and positive energies on you, and just about to open up wonderful possibilities for you, which is very, very good. So, in the fourth week, it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful energies in the fourth. As we look at the fourth week, we have the Wheel of Fortune, which is extremely wonderful, another lucky week. Another good positive week, the fifth week, and whatever it is, your fortune, your fortune lays overseas. For some people, your fortune lays overseas. Sometimes you can be someplace and you're not aware that that place is blocking what you're supposed to receive in your life. It's like the Wheel of Fortune is going to bring you to overseas, or you're going to go on a journey and you're going to find that true love that you have been looking for. For some people, this is going to be very much lucky. For some people, you are going to find money. Money is going to be coming from you at a worldwide. If you have a business, money is going to be coming from you worldwide. A lot of people I see are planning vacations, or you could be also astral traveling. For the people who are in the fourth and fifth dimension, you are astral traveling. I've seen there's a lot of traveling that is going on in your zodiac section now. So this is good. So remember, the second week and the fourth week is, and the third week is going to, as a matter of fact, you have no bad weeks as I look at it. Okay, as always, I change up my reading. There is something, whatever is happening, with, and if you're looking for a new house, it's going to happen. Okay, that house that you have been dreaming for, that house that you wanted, it is going to happen. So if you are looking for a new house, you are going to see that this is going to be happening for you. And that house is going to bring in a lot of positive energy into your world, and this is going to be good. Okay, so for the people who have been looking for a new house, the women are going to be vibrating a lot of nice energies. You are going to be feeling balanced. You're going to be feeling understanding. A lot of you Geminis are going to stretch the hand out to someone and say, I'm so sorry for I've misunderstood a situation and I'm so sorry. Some people are going to realize that other people are going to be coming back in your life, and you are going to be thinking if you want to let them back in your life. I am doing a little segment called the blessings of this reading, the blessings of this month, and we have the energy of the moon. And some of these decks, the moon can be your work, but some the moon can be psychic. Okay, so I will give two readings. If you receive messages, intuition messages, go for it. Whatever, as is good, as is something good, a lot of you are going to have some deep emotional connection, and some are going to have thoughts about money and creative things. So if you receive messages that you should do this, maybe it's good because it's creative. Go do it because it's going to bring you wonderful, wonderful, positive, wonderful, wonderful, positive situation in your life. Okay, so this is basically going to be good. Nice rich man. Some people are going to meet a nice rich man because I'm seeing the energy of these women, and especially the two women, you Geminis. So some of you are going to meet a nice rich man, and some of you are going to acquire a lot of money. But yet still, some of you can be going becoming alcoholics. Five glass of wine per night, you are an alcoholic. That's a glass of wine is okay. Five glass is that you are over that part in your life. So whatever the situation is, but it is going to be a very, very good, it's going to be extremely, extremely good, positive, positive time for you guys. A lot of you are going to be really connecting, really connecting, and it's going to be very positive for you guys. You're going to be connecting with wonderful, positive people in your life. There's a lot of new situations that are coming up. There's a lot of good situations that are coming up. There's a lot of positive situations that are coming up. And this is very good because whatever you're looking for, this is going to be happening for most of you guys. So it is really, really, a good positive time for changes to happen in your life. And a lot of good changes are going to be happening. So there we go. Sometimes I do the love. There is not much of a love sense. It's more a love of yourself trying to change situations. And these situations are going to be positive, and it is going to be good for most of you. As I look at this, it's going to be very positive for most of you. So this is going to be good. The Aries and the Pisces keep on coming up. Okay. All right. So let's go further and see what is happening for you Geminis. This is something that you need to know, what is happening for you Geminis. So let's see. For the sun sign Geminis. Okay. For the sun sign Geminis, you are going to have an effect. The Scorpios are going to have a huge effect on you. Remember that your sun sign, when you were born, 9 o'clock in the morning, and between 6 o'clock in the morning and 6 p.m. in the afternoon. Okay, and then we have the Scorpio, we have the Gemini, and we have Uranus. Uranus, Scorpio, Gemini, and Uranus. Now, these are certain planetary aspects, which is You know, it's really unbelievable how these can work and how you can see them and how they are positive. And you are going to see the Scorpions and the Gemini, and you are going to see Uranus, and this is going to be positive. Whatever the situation is, you're going to see positive situation coming here, coming about, and this is going to be very good. Okay, so whatever is happening, you need to know who you are and how understanding it is, for whatever reason, so you can be abreast of what is happening in your life. Okay, as we move forward, we have the energy vibration of the moon people. And who are the moon people? We have the energy vibration of the moon people coming up, and it's going to be the energy of the Pisces, the Aries, and the Aquarian. So this is going to be wonderful for you moon people, because you're working really together with the Pisces are very psychic people, and the Aquarians are very psychic. So this is going to be good, because they're helping you and your psychic energy to vibrate at an high-energy vibration. So this is going to be wonderful, and this is going to be positive. So whatever is happening, know that you are going to be receiving help from the Pisces, the Aquarians, and the Aries. So let's go forward and take a look to see whatever is happening. We are using the vortex, the energy of the vortex. So let's see what message is coming up for you, Geminis. I will envision the behavior I deserve to inspired. I will envision the behavior I deserve to inspire. Number 47 is the energy vibration of 11. So here we have another energy vibration of the 11, the number 11, and this is positive. So whatever is happening in your life, understand that positive things is about to happen for you. If we were a parent or anyone wanting to inspire positive behaviors from another, we would do our personal vibrational work first. We would align with our source energy by envisioning the outcome we seek, and by holding those involved as positive objects of our attention. We would not allow any current unwanted behaviors to be the reason for our attention to them. Okay, so this is wonderful, and this is positive. This is extremely good. I want to say to each and every person, enjoy your week. Namaste, until next week.